Today, I wanted to show you a few Unreal Engine tricks that you may not know or really looked for. But believe me, they save you time. So, when you have your project made, you will encounter this first problem, I would say, is that when you reopen Unreal Engine, you will land on this map or level. In order to avoid that, you can go just to Project Settings, Filter Maps, and in Editor Starter Map, you can just pick the correct one you want. And after you select the good one, you will always land on this level. Talking about project settings, you have three features really helpful in the editor preferences. When you go there and you just look for look and feel, you will have access to the combined translate rotate widget, arc ball rotate, and screen rotate. Let's see what we got here. So in your environment, let's say you have one asset and you want to manipulate it, you will often be kind of frustrated because you can really set up how you want your rotation or translation. You can of course switch off the snapping feature here, but let me show you if you enable the first one here, the enable combined translate. You have on the gizmo a little circle and this arrow, and this will help you to rotate in one widget that you will find here. So it's combining the translate and rotate, and you can easily put your asset where you want and rotate it like you want. Second one is the arc ball. You will have access to it when you enable it here and just turn rotation. And this will help you rotate by clicking here in the middle. And as you can see, you can rotate it just not with the classical axis, but in the middle of the widget. And the last one is the screen rotate. You will have now big circle around your widget or your gizmo, and it will rotate based on your screen point of view. You want to edit multiple texture or assets. You can do it via one feature. When you select multiple texture, let's say all the occlusion, right click, go to asset action, and go to bulk edit via property matrix. And when you go there, you will have access to all the common parameters you will find in one texture, but all wrapped up in one edit tab. Let's say you want to deactivate the sRGB of each one, you just have to click there. And this will help you even with assets if you want to enable, let's say, nanite or the preserve area for the nanite foliage. You can do here directly with right click, asset action, bulk edit via property matrix. One really cool thing I wanted to show you is about your outliner and all the folder managing. Let's say I want to place those two assets here in one folder. And everything I will create afterwards, I want it to be placed in this folder and avoid dragging, clicking one by one each asset by hand. What I can do here on the new folder one, just right click and make it the current folder. It changes color, you can see here the current context. And if you just, for example, pick a new sphere, here you can see automatically it would end up in the new folder one. Same for other assets. Last but not least, if you already used console command, you can find here in help and console variables all the command you need and their explanation. You can filter them with topics like rendered, sound, timer, etc. And this is really helpful if you use it a lot. So it's always a good point to have this. You can find really helpful and useful console command that you might not know, and a little extra tips for you guys. Of course, if you don't know it, if you enter, let's say, a console command here. And if you want to reuse it, you can just by the up arrow of your keyboard go and look for all the latest console command you enter. Let me know if you found it useful, if you already knew or not these 5 tips. And we decided to upload every week on Thursday one new tutorial. So stay tuned, make sure you subscribe to our channel and don't miss one tutorial. Bye bye guys, see ya!